Hurricane Earl will mean another few days of strong surf along our local coastline. Our team coverage continues now with West 2's Jeff Lennox, who explains that can be good or bad news for beachside businesses.
As Hurricane Earl and these other tropical systems churn out in the Atlantic, local business owners here in Brevard County are very concerned about the future of their businesses in the coming days and weeks.
It's not the sight a charter boat fishing captain wants to see on a Tuesday morning. An empty dock, a quiet marina.
We don't like it.
The scene of big waves and choppy surf is keeping Captain Albert Kelly's charter fishing boat docked.
Primarily, we're docked. We work on the boat.
On a normal day, Captain Kelly has close to 24 people on board. They head 20 miles offshore for some of the best fishing in the world. Not today, though.
That's where we fish. That's too dangerous to take anybody out there.
If these charter boats stay tied up much longer than a couple of weeks, it could mean thousands of dollars lost at sea.
A lot of money. This boat makes no money when it's sitting still. Hopefully, later this week, depending on the speed of Earl going up the coast, we may can get out, we may not.
So while this captain keeps close watch on the tropics, there's one industry that is stoked about the passing storms, surfing.
Thursday we're supposed to have like a 9-foot swell, so I'm stoked.
Surfers will unite this weekend for the 25th NKF Surf Fest at the Cocoa Beach Pier. With 8-foot waves expected, more surfers are signing up, and that means more cash is coming in.
It's the ideal condition. We used to come over from the Gulf Coast when the hurricanes come. I mean, they'll be coming from everywhere.
In Brevard County, Jeff Lennox, West 2 News.